reconvening into our public session. And I'd like to just welcome everybody who is here tonight in attendance and those who are streaming this or watching the live stream now, or to those who will watch it later on, welcome to you as well. And we are going to have our pledges. Mrs. Rucking.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Our Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to the city of Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Please remain standing, please, for a moment of silence. Dr. Scanzo, do we have any commendations and recognitions?
We do have a really, I think, very special commendation this evening, but before we do that, real pleased to introduce tonight's inspiring moment. So as when it goes to the podium, tonight's inspiring moment is about our first Humble ISD Leadership Academy. Really thanks to the generosity of some amazing community members, our Education Foundation, really the hard work of Dr. Price, Ms. Hayhurst, Ms. Arola, Ms. Yelcom, and Mr. Kramer. The Humble ISD Leadership Academy began this year and graduated its first class just a couple of weeks ago. So Winna, if you will roll the video, we're very, very, very proud to be able to offer this.
MLIC has been involved with, if you think about leadership opportunities, we have some who have been through doctorate. We have some who have gone through Rice's educational program, A-plus challenge at the time. Some of you from to Harvard, where they're in leadership.
All great programs, some of them are all speaking in one.
And so we had them there, running over and sort of talking about them. They wanted to get back. They wanted to help them along. So how can we make things better for future years? So we just started talking about what we were doing, what we were offering, and how we can make it better.
To have your own personalized leadership study in the district, I think that takes leadership from being theoretical and in the books to, here's what really happened.
Well, I've had three kids come through Humble ISD. I've got two that are done, and I've got a sophomore, just finished his sophomore year. And I thought maybe I might be able to contribute something. And so I got to know the Jerry Montgomery from the Education Foundation, and she and I talked about an initiative they had here with the district, and seemed like a good fit. So I said I'll contribute, and never quit.
I applied for the Leadership Academy because I saw it as an opportunity for me to grow personally. I've been through a lot of different professional development. I know a lot of things that are related to curriculum, but not so much with just leadership.
This was something I did like because usually in the composition that I was in, you grow in science or you grow in professional development. But this was an opportunity to grow in just leadership with a group within MLIC.
The uniqueness of the academy would be that it wasn't just educators, it was across the district, it was business office, public relations, whatever position was leadership.
Teachers, from instructional coaches, from assistant principals, associate principals, and coordinators, and people that are in community development are in, and the list goes on and on.
That's across the continuum. And there were district level administrators, classroom teachers, campus administrators, that we could all come together and share experiences.
First portion of the academy was all about personal reflection. It was about things that you do and how you interact with people and assumptions that you make.
As we went through each of the skills we consciously,
I remembered that at one point, I knew all of these skills, but you tend to forget just the hustle and bustle of working and trying to meet deadlines and trying to meet goals, that it is important to recognize differences. It is important to not isolate people. It's important to test assumptions.
I think coming into this program, we had to really reflect on what our strengths and weaknesses were. It gave it to us in a whole different perspective and made me really think about my thinking and think about how I was building relationships.
The peer group was an amazing component of the entire process, both in the fall semester and we had different peer groups in the spring semester. And it was a wonderful way to get to learn professionals with whom I not work regularly and may not have been able to communicate and learn from otherwise.
I grew very close to my peer group. We became the rock for each other. We were able to share issues that we have at work in a very non-threatening environment, a very safe environment.
During the second half of the academy, one thing that I really valued was the book study with the superintendents. I became very comfortable around them for the simple fact that they have all been where we are.
Whatever you aspire to, they've been there some way along their journey to where they are now. So having their perspective and their guidance and experiences, I think that was really, it really was the next step to this academy.
It is so reassuring to know that we have the support of our community. Obviously, we could not have had this experience without our educational foundation, our school board, our donors, assistant superintendents, everyone did an amazing job creating this experience for us.
Our job is to support. Our job is to push each and every one of those people to do better, to want more for the kids.
We are very, very proud of the program and look forward to it growing on a going forward basis. I do want to introduce you to some of the stars of tonight's video who are here this evening. Three of them now among the first graduates of the MYSD Leadership Academy. First, Vianda Maholi, academic lead teacher at Apple High School. Our director of advanced academics, Tempe Smith. To ask to see the middle school assistant principal, Steve Stanky. And for this program, I'll jump into the godfather, Dr. Tommy Price. Great work, thank you all very much. I'm going to ask Jerry Mondarin to come to the podium to introduce tonight's commendation, but I do want to make a comment as she makes her way there. Just a few weeks ago, literally lives were changed, and they were changed thanks to the generosity of someone who has long been very supportive of our district and our campuses, and most importantly, our kids, and I'm speaking of Randall Reed, the owner of Planet Four. Randall did it again a few weeks ago in a very, very big way. And Jerry, if you don't illustrate how big, I will, and you're finished, because it just blows me away how generous Randall is. But that event, that activity did change lives, and Jerry, if you'd be kind enough to introduce it this evening, Mr. President, if you will join me up front.
Sure. I'm going to show a few pictures about it as I'm talking. So tonight we are recognizing the outstanding support that Randall Reed and the Planet 4 team has provided to the students at Mobile ISD. Planet 4 has been a longtime supporter of Mobile ISD in a multitude of ways, supporting education programs in our classrooms, such as giving a book to every third grader at Oak Forest Elementary, an electronic marquee at Humble Middle School, supporting Project Grad through Drive 1 events, a brand new Ford car for our District Teacher of the Year, and the list goes on and on. And this past November, Mr. Reed extended that list even further by agreeing to take students from the Kingwood Park High School Best Buddies program to Disney World. So how this happened was in November, Mr. Reed was informed that he would be the recipient of a prestigious Salute to Dealer Award. Ford Motor Company wanted to send a video crew down to interview him. Mr. Reed was a big fan of the Best Buddies program and saw this as an opportunity to promote awareness about this program. So he asked if he could be videotaped at Kingman Park High School talking to the students. In the case of if you aren't aware of Best Buddies, it is an MSA dedicated to creating opportunities for one-to-one friendship